Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the digital transducers. Now we are going to discuss the sliding contact encoder for the digital signal generation. Up till now, what we have seen the digital transducers and the optical encoder for the digital signal generation. Now we have to focus on the topic sliding contact encoder. What do you mean by sliding contact encoder, or how the signal is generated in the sliding contact encoder? Let us see. So as you can see here, the diagram which is representing the sliding contact encoder here. What you can see, these are the sliding contact brush, these are the conducting metal areas, and these are the commutator brush. So when the shaft is rotating, there is a sliding contact between the brush and the commutator brush and the conducting areas, the signal is generated. Now let us see how does it happen. In the sliding contact encoder, all the conducting areas are connected to the common slip ring. You can see common slip rings are there. The conducting areas, these are the conducting metal areas, are connected to the common slip ring on the encoder shaft by using the brush mechanism. So these are the sliding brush contact, this is commutator brush. So what is happening here, all the contacting areas or all the conducting areas are connected to the common slip ring on the encoder shaft using the brush mechanism. Now a sliding contact such as brush, so this is what the sliding contact we can say. So the sliding contact such as brush touches the each track. So these are the tracks. So it touches the each track as the disc rotates. So when the disc is rotating, so it touches the each track and a voltage pulse signal is picked up by it. So this is how the voltage peak signal is generated. So how this voltage pulse signal is generated? When a sliding contact such as brush touches a track and as the disc rotates, a voltage pulse signal is generated. So this is how the voltage pulse is generated in the sliding contact encoder. Now what are the advantages of the sliding contact encoder? So this must be having the high sensitivity. It is having very simple in construction and it have the high sensitivity and low cost. So it gives you the high sensitivity. It is having the low cost and it is very simple in the construction. So these are some advantages related to the sliding contact encoder. Now what are the disadvantages of that? So the friction, wear, brush bounce due to vibration. So the accuracy depends upon the precision of the conducting pattern of the encoder disc. So due to the friction, sometimes it will not give you the desired output. And your accuracy is depending upon the precision of the conducting pattern of the encoder disc. So these are some disadvantages related to the sliding contact encoder. So what we have seen in the sliding contact encoder, that it is having a conducting areas are connected to the common slip ring on the encoder shaft. So this is, you can say this is the encoder shaft and the conducting metal areas are there and these are using the brush mechanism. And due to that brush mechanism, when the brush touches the each track, when the brush touches these kind of tracks and the disc rotates, a voltage pulse like this is generated. So this is related to the sliding contact encoders. We have seen the advantages and the disadvantages for these sliding contact encoders. Now let us focus on the magnetic encoders. What do you mean by magnetic encoders? So the magnetic encoder that saturates the core of the transformer, increasing the reluctance. So this is simple diagram for the magnetic encoder. So these are the magnetic spots you can see here. This is primary supply. So this is nothing but we can say this is the transformer unit. And here we are getting the output. And this is the ferromagnetic disc. So what is happening here in the magnetic encoder? The transformer are used. This is primary supply. Where we can use the V reference, that is reference voltage we are using. And we are getting the output voltage V0. So through this transformer, the reference voltage we have to give. And we are getting the output over here. So in this, magnetic area saturates the core of the transformer, increasing reluctance. So magnetic spots are used here. That saturates the core of the transformer increased. So in this magnetic encoders, high strength magnetic area are imprinted on the encoder disc, as you can see here. This is the high strength magnetic area which is imprinted on the disc. So this can be used for the etching, stamping or the recording. Signal pick of the device is micro transformer, which has primary and the secondary windings on the circular ferromagnetic core. So this is the circular ferromagnetic core on which the transformer primary and the secondary windings are present. So what are the advantages of this magnetic encoder? This causes the induced voltage to drop. And the advantages are magnetic encoders have the non-contacting pickup sensors. So what is the advantages? So these are having the non-contacting type pickup sensors. So this is related to the magnetic encoders. Now the next method for the generation of the signal is proximity sensor encoder. Now, what do you mean by proximity sensor encoder? Let us focus. So this is the simple circuit diagram for the proximity sensor encoder. For this proximity sensor encoder, this green color shows the proximity sensor, and which gives you the output. These are the encoder shaft. These are the raised spots, or we can say ferromagnetic core. These are plated conducting material, that is eddy current. So the magnetic induction probe or the eddy current can be used for the magnetic induction. That is ferromagnetic core or the eddy current can be used for the magnetic induction, and disc is of ferromagnetic type of material. So it is used for the flux linkage, we can say. So it uses the proximity sensors, as I shown you. This green color is for the proximity sensors. So the proximity sensors are signal pick off element. So they can sense the signal, for example, magnetic induction probe or the eddy current probe. So these magnetic sensors are used for the sensing the magnetic induction probe or the eddy current probe. So this is how the signal is picked up by the magnetic sensors. And the magnetic induction disc is of ferromagnetic and raise the areas change in the flux linkage. The eddy current disc is plated with the conducting materials. So this is how the proximity sensor encoder is used for the digital signal output, for the production of the digital signal output. So this is how we have seen the digital signal generation methods like sliding contact encoder, magnetic encoder, and the proximity sensor encoder. Thank you.